Have you ever tried running a motor with power supply that has current output slightly higher than the motor's rated current, but still noticed power supply failing to power the motor? It's due to the characteristics of electric motors, nothing wrong with the power supply. This circuit is regular PWM speed controller with one extra feature added to it. Previously this motor tripped the power supply's current protection I've set, but now it runs fine. Even if you aren't building this exact circuit, I'll tell you why this works. The circuit is built on my custom perf board I've gotten from the sponsor of this video, PCBWAY.com. They have produced great quality PCBs for my projects, and I'm about to order some new PCBs for my upcoming projects. I can highly recommend them for your prototypes as well. So why does the power supply sometimes fail powering the motor, even though the current capability should be high enough? Well, the simplified equivalent circuit of regular DC motor is voltage source with some resistance in series. The resistance includes, for example, resistance of the windings and brushes. Voltage source voltage is directly proportional to the RPM, being zero when stopped. That means the current going through a stalled or stopped motor will be input voltage over motor's resistance, which is quite low. That is the current motor tries to pull, but it can start with lower current and voltage as well. As soon as motor starts spinning, this internal voltage will go up and current will drop. Rated current isn't the stall current, but a current that motor could handle continuously. Now the extra feature I've added to my PWM controller is current limiting. Each PWM pulse starts normally, but output will be disabled for the rest of the PWM pulse if the output current reaches the threshold value. This is repeated for each and every pulse, which is why this is called pulse-by-pulse current limiting. I have made this using simplest PSoC 4 chip. The PSoCs have PWM component which has a feature that many other microcontrollers don't have. It's the input signal called stop. This can be triggered from hardware or software, and it can be configured to stop on kill or not stop on kill. When stop signal event is don't stop on kill, stop input signal causes kill operation making the output inactive but doesn't stop the counter. Stop on kill would also stop the counter. Next setting is kill signal event, which I've set synchronous, which kills the output as long as the kill signal is high, and once it goes low, the PWM output will not be re-enabled until terminal count comes, which means when the next pulse starts. The stop signal's present checkbox needs to be checked to make it available on the hardware side. I have set PWM period based on input clock value giving desired output frequency. What frequency and how fine control over duty cycle you need depends on your project. I just need a couple of selectable speeds, so I'm happy with these values. Duty cycle will be ratio of compare and period values. I want to start at 0, motor stopped, so I'll set the compare to 0 in this configuration. PWM component's now visible stop signal is connected to an actual input pin. I'll show you in a moment how that is connected on the PCB. Line, or the main output, goes to an output pin. In my circuit, push button cycles through different speeds. It can't change the value of PWM timer directly. It will be connected to an interrupt component instead, and in the ISR code, I'll programmatically change the PWM duty cycle. In the pinout configuration, I've designated those pins from schematic to actual pins. Here's the source code. I have an array of PWM compare values for different duty cycles. In main function, I've pointed interrupt component to use my own interrupt service routine and started the PWM component. The ISR cycles through the array of speeds one step per interrupt and writes currently selected value to the PWM module. Short delay is added to act as a debouncing for the button. This is the schematic drawn based on my circuit. This is for reference only. I made the circuit component by component without a schematic and drew this afterwards. I have push button with pull-up resistor connected to one pin. Another pin controls MOSFET, which connects motor's negative wire to ground through 0.1 ohm resistor. voltage drop of that shunt resistor goes to non-inverting input of the LM393 comparator, and inverting input gets reference voltage from the potentiometer that is connected as a voltage divider, dividing the forward voltage of generic diode. Diode's forward voltage is 0.7 volts, and potentiometer's output is therefore 0 to 0.7 volts. When that is compared to 0.1 ohm shunt voltage drop, this comparator can be adjusted to trigger on motor currents between 0 and 7 amps. When current is below threshold, this comparator pulls its output low. After current reaches the threshold, output is released and pull-up resistor pulls it high, triggering the PWM component's stop signal and disabling the pulse going to the MOSFET gate. The current limiting that is set to slightly higher current than the rated current only affects the motor at startup or stall situations. When motor is running within its rated current range, current limiting doesn't interfere with the PWM signal. This was another application where PSoC features are super useful. The components or modules are powerful and easy to configure. I can recommend them if you are tinkering with different microcontrollers. See you next video. Thanks.